In a resource-constrained environment, it's very important for me, and I know I keep saying the same word, outcomes, 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 but it becomes more important to prove what you're able to do with the money. Budgeting for outcome forces or encourages collaboration between agencies, but it also gets us focused on the outcomes, and I talk about the outcomes because it also forces that conversation when we talk about the after-school programming, because we've been tracking, because we have a good partner with the Family League of Baltimore that shows the data, that shows that absenteeism is down for the kids that are participating in the program, behavioral problems have been reduced, you know, the grades have been supported. Because we have that, we can go to our partners and say, we will be a responsible partner because we are interested in, you know, not who has the glossiest, proposal, but who's given us the best results, and we have the track record to prove it. So just as we are focused on outcomes in the city budget, because we're focused on outcomes in the programming for young people, I think, are laying the foundation for good collaboration, and that's what you have to do, again, when you're in an economically constrained environment. You have to, you know, you flip the sofa cushions, you look for your money, and then you figure out how you can stretch it, right, as much as possible. And you have to make sure that people know that you're going to be a good steward with the resources that we're sharing.
Well, foundations don't usually poke around in the sofa cushions, but the cost effectiveness is also.
I don't know. You haven't met my boss.
Cost effectiveness is equally a serious issue for funders. What's your take on the balancing act between figuring out the most cost-effective approaches and the desire to lift all after-school providers together?
Almost everybody who's in this business loves kids. But the reality is, this is about the kids. And I think cost-effectiveness is absolutely critical. We need to have programs for every child who wants one. We don't have all the money that we want to do it. We have to figure out how to spread those dollars effectively and efficiently. This is a new system, and we're learning about what size works, what level of resources work, who is best at providing what kinds of services for what kids. And I expect over the next several years that we're going to get a lot better. And it may mean that programs have to merge. It may mean that we can't afford to have, you know, seven little tiny programs in one school. And I, you know, it's very difficult to realize, to have to say that kind of thing to folks who've put their heart and soul into it. But at the end of the day, it is about our children and not so much about the people who run programs, and they're second. So I would say we care a whole lot about that. We care a whole lot about covering all as many children as we can effectively and efficiently.
Can I add to that?
Absolutely.
To your point about having those tough decisions, that's what this new normal after the Great Recession is requiring, I think, of all of us, to have those tough conversations. Just like you talked about, you might not be able to have seven little programs. We had to have that same conversation around recreation centers.
Yes.
Because we had, for so long, the easy thing to do was to budget just enough so you could keep all the buildings open. And there was no, after the budget season was over, no one then asked the question, well, what are we doing for those kids after they come in? Do we have enough staff? But, you know, we could all pat ourselves on the back and say, we kept all the buildings open. But you can't say that you care about the kids if your focus is on keeping the buildings open.
That's true.
It has to be about providing the best opportunities, the best programming for our young people. So we had to start having those tough conversations. And for electeds, the tougher part is, will you be willing to be the one that closed a rec center? Well, if it means we're closing it so we can invest in better programming, yes.